Welcome back. Well, today you can celebrate a piece of Texas history. It's the 22nd annual Pioneer Day out in Dripping Springs, which recreates the early days of our state. Joining me today is Wanda Malden from the Dr. Joseph Pound Historic Farmstead to talk to us about it. And you brought some of your models with you, a page right out of Little House on the Prairie almost.
Right.
Talk about today's event.
Well, we're having the smokehouse. The smokehouse exhibit is opening up today.
Okay.
And then we have arts and craft for the kids, candle making.
Uh-huh.
And we are having.
There's stagecoach rides.
There's
right?
a wagon ride.
Wagon rides.
And
cooking demonstrations.
Yes, and there's gonna be a band out there playing, old music.
Kind of folksy type of music.
Right.
So this obviously is a big deal to preserve this part of our Texas history. Why do you feel like that's such a big deal?
It's just nice to have the history of Dripping Springs and people see how people lived back then.
Uh-huh.
And how they did their food and they cooked outside. And
yeah.
It's just.
We have it good now.
Right, we really do. So
this takes us back to the old settler days. What are some of the items that you'll kind of have on display out there?
Well, this is one. It's a tooth puller.
And this is what I meant by we have it good now.
Right.
This is a tooth puller.
It's a tooth puller.
Right.
And then this is what he made his medicine in.
Okay.
And then this is just some of the canning that we have out there, and this is a quilt that Sarah and her daughters had made, and then here's some old-fashioned candy that
and
we have.
And when you say him, you're referring to Dr. Pound?
I'm sorry, her, Sarah Pound.
Oh, Sarah
his,
Pound,
his
okay.
wife, they made the quilts,
mm-hmm.
and the daughters.
Mm-hmm.
They had 9 children.
Okay.
And then this is a butter press, and at the bottom of it has the P.O.
Oh, wow.
For Pound. So, and then this here is a, they made their own beer.
Bottles, uh-huh.
Beer, and they would cap it to sell it. And then we have the jelly maker, which you would put your grapes in here, and the juice would fall down in here, and this would catch some of it.
Uh-huh.
But you would mash it, and then you would pour it into the jars.
So all of this will be out on display today at the historic site. How, describe the site to us. Is it like its own little town
homestead.
Out there?
It's a homestead.
Uh-huh.
It's just a homestead. It's where that they came from Mississippi, and they built there in Dripping Springs, and they were the first settlers. He was the first doctor there.
And how many people will be participating out there at the Pioneer Day?
Oh, that's going to be a lot.
Right.
Because we have booths out there, too.
Okay.
So there's going to be different things for everybody.
All ages,
yes.
Right, there's a lot of kid-friendly events
right,
out there.
Right, there is.
Mm-hmm. Cooking so, demonstrations, some barbecue.
Barbecue, ice cream is going to be out there. So
over the 22 years, how much has it changed?
It's changed a lot.
Yeah, even though the history doesn't change.
Right.
But the event itself.
Yeah, we just restored, restoring the home the way as it was back in 1914.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's come a long ways.
And all the proceeds from today benefit the foundation for the preservation of
that
homestead site. Wonderful, yeah. Pioneer Day starts at 10.
At 10 to 4.
10 to 4 today
to 4.
Out near Dripping Springs.
Dripping Springs, right off Ranch Road 12.
And 290.
And 290. And you take a ride on Ranch Road 12, and about a mile down the road, you'll come to a sign that says Founders Park.
And then you found it.
And you find it. You just come on up past the pool and...
All right.
And you'll come to it.
Well, thank you so much, and best of luck with the event today.
Thank you.